and he trained me, I think, like, really well, if I do say so myself.
What has tour been like for you? It looks like you've been pretty much everywhere.
Yeah, we are in a new city every day, so that's been kind of wild. Like, you never know where you're going to wake up. Well, I mean, you do know, but I don't, because I don't keep track. But it's been great. I think performing in front of a live audience is like a drug, and I think that's why so many people do it. It does. It gives you such a rush that you know, want like more and more of. But sleeping on the tour bus is a challenge. I think not everyone has that problem, but I do. So that's always like the first thing to come out of my mouth when people ask about tour. But other than that, it's just, it's really fun. And it's, you know, just like another experience.
And then obviously on the show, you did really well, finished second. What do you think the most rewarding part of this whole experience has been for you?
I think just like there's been different kinds of reward for sure. One big one during the show that was like very tangible was just learning a new skill. You know, the amount of time it takes to learn a new skill to this level, like not just ballroom dance, but like as an adult, we don't really pick up new things. And we were practicing dance like 5, 6, 7 hours a day. So it's like nobody has that time, but I was getting paid to like do something fun. And you just really like watched your body change and got to see yourself do this new thing that you never thought you'd be able to do. So that it's in itself was really rewarding. And of course, just the relationships that come with it, like meeting new people and Dancing with the Stars has really been a family.
Yeah. Speaking of the people, I guess, who was there a coolest star to kind of work with and get to know during this process?
Everyone was really great. It is like you kind of do keep to yourself. Especially like with COVID, they try and keep us separate. But naturally, I got to know Vinny pretty well. He was great. And I'm trying to think who. Charlie's great. Wayne. I mean, everyone's been like really amazing to work with. So.
Yeah, I did see you and Vinny jokingly flirting on Instagram. Saw that was a big deal.
Yeah, I know. Everyone ate that up. But we just kind of like built a friendship. We have similar senses of humor. We were at the studio like around the same time a lot. So naturally just got to know each other. But he was great. It's nice to, you know, and when he came on tour for those couple of days, it's nice just to have like a friend, like an outsider. This isn't our world. And normally I'm here like by myself. But so it's nice to have like a comrade.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. And how was it working with Val?
That was amazing. We built a friendship like right away, and he's really, really great at what he does. I mean, I think anyone who watches him dance knows how talented he is, and he trained me, I think, like really well, if I do say so myself. But he was amazing. We had such a great time together.
And then obviously it's probably still totally different, but how do you think your cheer background helped you with this?
I think like just performing, you know, I do feel for people who have never like ever really like performed, because it is a little bit of a persona. Like it comes with confidence, and just kind of like faking it till you make it. And that, so I think that part really helped me. Like when you step foot on stage, like something does need to come inside of you to where, you know, you're putting on a performance and you have to like kind of be somebody different, for that like minute and a half, 2 minutes. So that helped. But of course, like ballroom dance was completely different. I've never performed this much or in this like intimate of settings, you know, in Broncos. Our stadium holds 77,000 people, which is an intimidating number, but you know, nobody's really paying attention to you. So nobody really cares. So it was all like kind of calming in that way. Whereas we're performing in front of like 2, 3, 4, I think sometimes 10,000 people, but they're all really paying attention to you. So that is actually more intimidating.
Yeah. What was the most difficult dance for you, do you think?
The Paso Doble definitely was the most difficult dance for me to pick up. I think it clicked, you know, right in time, and it was really fun to perform, but learning it was really difficult.
Yeah. What were the ins and outs, I guess, of learning that one?
It was just, it's a really different dance. It's not very feminine. They call it a man's dance. So me, especially like as a cheerleader and just as a person, I'm very soft and feminine. So when I have to be really strong and assertive, it feels like I don't as easy go into that character. So that was kind of hard. And then our song in particular was an amazing song, and it was like true classic Paso Doble, but the tempo actually changed during it. So it changed tempo like mid-song. So counting it was really hard. You didn't ever know like what beat you were on.
And then I hadn't really thought of this until now, but you performing all the time, practicing every day, I guess, what was your recovery process like through all that?
I went to the sauna a lot, which helped. I tried to go to the sauna like 3-4 times a week. They have a great physical therapist there. I did have like a little shoulder rotator cuff injury towards the end, so I was just really trying to baby that. It's a common injury among like ballroom dancers with your connecting hand, so like you're constantly engaged there, and just trying to get rest, which was impossible, but really just paying attention to your injuries. Like as a nurse, I feel like I'm really in tune with my body, so just paying attention to it and like giving whatever your body needs at the time.
So what do you think was the most challenging for you, being one of the women on The Bachelor, being the woman on The Bachelorette, and then, or Dancing with the Stars?
They were all really challenging in their different ways. I will say, like, each one prepared me for the next, you know? So, I don't know. Dancing was definitely the most, like, physically intense, obviously. So that was hard. And it was like just as much time, but you had distraction. So I would like try and make plans with friends, but ended up bailing because I was just too tired. But Bachelor, Bachelorette, they take your phones. So you have, you know, that's all you think about during that time. So yeah, it's a hard question to answer. One, obviously Bachelorette and Bachelor is like more emotionally challenging, which I'd probably take the physical over emotional any day.
Yeah. What's it like not having any contact with the outside world while you're there?
It's hard because, you know, your family like just is constantly thinking about you, your friends, but I would say it's like probably harder for them, like as the person, you know. It's actually kind of refreshing knowing that you can live life without your phone, and you do immediately. You're just way more present in life.
And once tour is all wrapped up and everything, I guess what's next for you? Do you think you'll be on any other shows or anything?
I would love to be on any kind of show. I love like TV. But I don't know. I don't really know what's next. Tour goes for a while until March. So just kind of seeing what comes my way and playing it by ear. That's what I've done for the last year and a half, and it's led me here. So